light of the world, you step down into darkness. Open my eyes, let me see beauty that made this heart adore you. Hope of a life spent with you. Here I am to worship, here I am to bow down, here I am to say that you're my God. You're all together loving, all together worthy, all together wonderful to me. King of all days, oh so highly exalted, glorious in heaven above. Humbly you came to the earth you created, all for love's sake became born. Here I am. Upon that cross, I'll never know how much it cost to see my sin.
For those of you that think that gospel music has gone too far, you think we've gotten too radical with our message, well, I got news for you. You ain't heard nothing yet. And if you don't know, now you know. Glory, glory! Woo! You better put them hands together and act like you know up in here. Cheap Pete!
Lately, I've been going through some things that's really
my joy, devil. Makes me cut. Put them hands together and have a Holy Ghost party with me. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. I'm more than a conqueror. Can I get a witness up in here?
Lightning flash from above. Take the pain away. Hold on, Carolina. We understand.
I will
that,
say
that
family and friends
for everyone's presence
closure.
Here.
For this service is especially
a bit of understanding
for those of us here in New York and
so
who have come from further away who can't make it to the
widow
funeral
and
that will
the
be in North
in
Carolina.
Prayers.
And for those
we understand
of you who
that will be able to make it,
family and friends all need closure.
We ask that you bring
perhaps a bit of understanding
to
as far as
also.
What has happened. So we ask that
with
you
that,
keep his widow
again,
Brianna
thank you
and the children
for
in your prayers.
Getting up early
and for those
in the morning
who will be able to make it.
This was no ordinary young man.
You know,
we ask
well
that you
loved,
bring blessings and love
and peace to the
it
family
shows.
Also, even now. So
with that.
We will begin our
again,
memorial
thank
service
you
for
everyone for
getting up early in the morning. But
Delva.
This was no
and
ordinary young man.
With a scripture
he was well loved
by Ian
and
Jean-Claude.
It shows even now. So with that, we will begin our memorial service for the life of Roland Junior Delva.
Good morning, everyone.
And that begins with
today,
a scripture
I'm
reading.
I'm going to be reciting to you
Jean-Claude.
Psalm 139. You have searched me, Lord, and you know me. You know when I sit and when I rise. You perceive my thoughts from afar.
Good morning, everyone.
You discern my going out and
today,
my lying down.
I'm going to be
reciting to
with
you
all my ways.
Psalm 139.
Before a word is on my tongue, you, Lord, know it completely.
You have searched me, Lord, and you know
me.
Behind
and before.
You know when I sit and when I rise.
Upon me.
You perceive
such
my thoughts from afar.
Too wonderful for me.
You discern my
too
going out and my lying down. You're familiar
I go
with all my ways.
Before
where can
a word
I flee
is
from on my
presence?
Tongue?
You,
if I
Lord,
go to the heavens, you are there.
You
if I make my mind in the
before,
depths, you are there.
And you lay
if
your
I rise
hand
in the wings
me.
Of the dawn,
such
if
knowledge
I settle
is
on
too
the far
wonderful
side of the
me.
Sea,
too lofty
even there
for
your
me
hand
to
will guide me. Your right
where
hand
can I go
will hold
from
me
your
fast.
Spirit?
Where
if
can I flee from your
darkness
presence?
Will hide me?
If I go up to the heavens, you are there.
The night will be
if I make my bed in the depths, you are there.
The darkness will not
if I rise in the wings
you.
Of the dawn,
the night will shine
if
like
I settle
the day,
on the far side of the
for
sea,
darkness is his light
even
you.
There your hand will guide
for
me.
You created my inmost
your right
being.
Hand will hold me fast.
Knit me together in my
if
mother's
I say
womb.
Surely the darkness will hide me
because I am fearfully and wonderfully made.
The night will become light around me. Even the darkness will not be dark to you.
My frame was not hidden.
The night will shine like the day.
When I was made in the
for darkness is his light to you.
When I was woven together
for you created my inmost being,
you knit me
your
together
saw
in my
mother's
body.
All
I
the days
you because
I am
me
fearfully and wonderfully
book.
Made.
Before I want them to
your works are
before
wonderful,
one of them
I know that
be.
Full well.
How
my frame was not
you,
hidden from
God.
You.
How
when I was made
the
in
the
secret
them.
Place.
Where I count
when
them,
I was woven together in
them,
the depths of the earth.
Number the grains of sand.
Your eyes
when
saw
I'm
my
awake,
unformed body.
I'm still with you.
All the days ordained for
if
me were written in
God would
book.
Slay the wicked.
Before I want them to
away from those
before
who are
one of them came to be. They speak of you
how
with
precious
evil intent.
Your thoughts, God.
Your adversaries
the
sum of
your
name.
Where
I
do
count
I not
them,
hate those who
count
hate
to them,
you, Lord.
It would outnumber the grains
of sand.
Those who are in rebellion against
when
you.
When I'm awake, I am still
nothing
with
but
you.
But hatred for them.
If only you,
I
God, would
my
slay
enemies.
The wicked.
Away
from
me,
those
God,
who are
bloodthirsty.
Test me
they
in the
speak of you with
thoughts.
Evil intent.
See if there's
your
any
adversaries misuse your name.
And leave me
do
in
I not hate those who hate you, Lord?
Amen.
And abhor those who are in rebellion against you. I have nothing but hatred for them. I count them my enemies. Search me, God, and know my heart. Test me and know my anxious thoughts. See if there's any offensive way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting. Amen.
Good morning, everyone. Even though I am here to pray, I would like to take a few seconds to say this because I may not ever have another opportunity to say it. Good morning, everyone. Upon hearing about that, even though I am here to pray, I keep on visioning adolescent junior. I may not ever have another
whom
opportunity
I used to
drive
to the church.
Upon hearing about
to
that
the youth,
shocking tragedy
to home,
I keep
to
on visioning adolescent
so
Kensia,
close,
adolescent
close
junior
to me.
Whom I used to drive
always
to the church,
express a great deal of respect
for Pastor Dumi.
To whom,
let us pray.
To Grand Kai,
there was so
Heavenly
close,
Father,
close
that
me.
Is in the name
Junior,
of Jesus.
Always,
we are assembled here in this sanctuary
for Pastor
Dumi. In your holy presence,
let us pray.
In memoriam of our beloved and
Heavenly Father.
That is in
Roland
the name
Junior Delva
of Jesus,
whom
We are assembled here in this sanctuary, going to miss
in
your holy presence.
But Lord God,
in memoriam of our beloved,
we are imploring your favor.
Departed Roland Junior Delva.
We continue,
Jesus, to implore your
favor.
We are
missing
whom
we're going to miss.
Family. We are
but
all
Lord
afflicted.
God,
we are all.
Glory
we are imploring
God.
Your favor.
And
in other words,
situation,
we continue
together,
Jesus, to implore your favor.
But Lord God,
towards
we
us,
know
towards
with you,
we are
with
all
you
afflicted.
And your
we
mercy,
their strength.
Glory to God.
Lord God, we believe
in this situation together.
You are about to heal our wounds.
But Lord God,
we know with you.
Lord God, we can remember
with you
King
and
David,
your mercy,
your servant,
their strength.
Just you was
Lord
about
God, we
to
believe.
Depart from the earth.
You are about to heal our
he
wounds.
He calls his son Solomon, saying
Lord
that
Lord God, we can remember
King
I'm
David,
about to
your
go
servant.
The way of all the earth.
Just he was about to
cause David, the servant of
depart
God,
from the earth.
He was going to leave this earth.
He calls eternity. His son Solomon,
saying that
Lord God, we know.
I'm about to go the way of
no
all the earth.
Suffered like Job, your servant,
cause David
was
the servant
lost
of God knew
everything.
He was going to leave this earth for eternity.
But your servant Job,
Lord God, we know,
and his spiritual
I believe
and
moral myself,
resilience.
No one ever suffered like Job,
says Lord,
your servant,
who you has lost everything
you have taken.
May your name,
but your servant Job,
be glorified.
And his spiritual and moral resilience,
his faith,
says Lord,
and then
you
Lord
have
God,
given
your mercy,
you have taken,
you have restored.
May your name,
everything,
be glorified,
which he has lost.
And Job kept
you heal
his
Job's
faith,
wound.
And
that
then Lord
the
God, in your mercy.
Hope.
We are before you
today.
You have restored
morning.
Everything.
Believe you're gonna heal this
which
family.
He has lost.
Glory to God.
You heal all Job's wound.
That
Glory
is in
God.
The same
we
hope.
Believe in you, Jesus.
We are before you today.
Even
this
though we might be in the midst
believe
of
you're gonna
no
heal
matter
this
what
family.
Situation.
Glory to God.
You are
all
God.
Of us.
And you say, I am God,
God,
I change
we
now.
Believe in you, Jesus.
And in every situation, even though
we as brothers
might
and
be
sisters,
in the
as Christians,
of, no matter what situation,
God,
we continue
you
to
are
give
God.
You praise.
And
you say, I am God, I
continue
change
to
not.
Worship you.
And in every situation,
we believe in your word in the book
we,
of Revelation,
as brothers and sisters,
chapter
as Christians,
21, the verse 4.
Lord God,
one day
we continue.
To give
Jesus
you
upon your
and glory,
continue
Return.
To worship you,
because we believe in your word in the book of Revelation,
chapter 21, the verse
no
4.
No pain.
One day will come.
No death.
Jesus, upon your seeking,
we believe.
Return
that.
And we pray
again.
You're going to wipe away,
give strength
tears.
For everyone.
Suffering no more.
And
no
this pain,
particularly
no
death.
Another day and of blessings.
And everyone
believe
life,
that.
Particles.
And we pray again.
Give
all
strength
close,
for everyone.
Relatives.
And this day
glory to
shall
God,
be
beginning
with sister.
Another Ola, day and of
Kenya,
blessings.
And everyone
and
else.
Everyone life.
Lord God, in
particles.
Jesus' name we believe, we pray.
Amen. Amen.
All
close
relatives,
glory to God,
beginning with Sister Roland,
Kensia,
and everyone else.
Lord God, in Jesus' name we believe, we pray.
This moment we're going to have a
Amen.
Poetry by Carl
Amen.
Jean-Claude, followed by a blessing and song by Rebecca Dimash. This moment we're going to have a word of poetry by Carlton.
We all know Roland Junior Delva,
and
if he was here right now he'd make us laugh. So I think I should start off by saying thank you to all the ugly people that showed up here today. We all know
in the gentle embrace of sorrow's tide.
Now he'd make us laugh.
We gather here.
I think I should start off by saying thank you to all the ugly people that showed up here today.
Amidst the echoes of memories past, we find solace in love that forever lasts. In the gentle embrace of sorrow's tide,
hand in hand,
we gather here.
Let us heed the call to understand.
Spirits tried.
That our presence
amidst
here and now
the echoes of memories past
speaks volumes of love.
We find
in
solace
earnest vow
in love that forever lasts.
For in the tapestry of time we weave
today as we stand
moments
hand
of joy,
in hand,
moments to grieve.
Let us heed the call to
it's
understand
the presence we share
that
day
our
by
presence
day,
here and now
that lights the path
speaks volumes of
come
love
what may
in earnest vow.
Yet amidst the
for
laughter,
the tapestry
amidst
of time
tears,
we weave
lies the
moments of joy, moments
fears
to grieve.
It's regrets the presence whisper softly
day by day
in the night that lights
wishing
the path
for moments lost from
come
sight
what may. Yet amidst the laughter, amidst the tears, lies the weight of unspoken
oh,
fears.
How we wish we'd call a bit more.
Regrets whisper softly
text
in
a
the
bit
night
more
as we
wishing
explore
for moments lost
the
from
depths
sight
of longing, the ache of loss, a bridge of presence
worth the cost.
Oh, how we wish
in this
we'd call
gathering
a bit more.
Let humor find
text
its place
a bit more.
It touches
as we
lightness
explore
the
in
depths of
embrace
longing, the ache of loss.
A
for
bridge of presence
tears,
worth the cost.
Laughter ring.
In
but in
shared,
this gathering,
let hearts sing.
Let humor find its place.
It touches
so let
lightness
us cherish the moments we hold
in sorrow's embrace.
Let love be the story forever told.
For in our presence here
for
today,
amidst the tears,
we find the strength to light
ring
the way.
In memory
rest
shared,
easy, dear cousin,
let hearts sing.
In heaven's embrace,
in our hearts.
So let us cherish the moments we hold.
Trace.
Let love be the story forever told. For in our presence here today, we find the strength to light the way.
Rest easy, dear cousin,
in heaven's embrace,
in our hearts.
Your presence will forever trace.
Entends-tu la tempête et ses terribles accents? Parle, Seigneur, il arrête.
Mais
sauve tes enfants et ses terribles accents. Parle, Seigneur. À nos cris prête l'oreille, sauve-nous, nous t'aimons silence. Il parle aux flots en démence,
il est notre délivrance.
Mon cœur qui chancelle traverse les grandes eaux et l'orage à ma nacelle livre de rudes assauts. Oh, qui verra ma détresse, d'où me viendra le secours? Seigneur, je m'adresse,
que c'est à toi que je recours. Il parle aux flots en démence. La mer, les vents font silence. Paix vous soit, il est notre délivrance. Paix vous soit.
Remarks from Derland and Natalie Louisson, followed by a congregational hymn, and you'll find that on the back of your program, and then a tribute of memories by Kensia Ogle.
Morning. I'm going to do my best. And I'm going to hold it down for me and Natalie for today. Just like Carlton said, I'm pretty sure Junior would have us laughing in some capacity. So if you guys could join me with a collective, you're... Okay, thank you. I'm freaked out, but I'm going to do my best. Growing up, Junior and I were siblings. Whenever I looked at him, I saw him as my brother. We were in sync, moving through life together until adulthood. And distance decided to bring its curveballs. I moved to Boston. He left to the military. They all played their part in pulling us apart physically, but our bond remained strong. Then Junior kept lifing more than I did. Had kids, got married. We used to joke about being next in, that I would be next in line for those milestones, envisioning our futures intertwining perfectly. I used to tell him all the time that he'd walk me down the aisle when my day comes. No offense, Pops. But life isn't always that neat. Tuna, a name that I gave him a while back, was blessed with guidance and mentorship from his cousins, Odie and Carlton, my brother James, in a way that was both profound and occasionally hilariously off track. James and Junior's deep dives into life, the universe, and everything often went into rants best left to our imagination. Witnessing their exchanges, I couldn't help but appreciate the blend of serious mentorship and those you had to be there moments of humor. James has a thing of mixing life lessons with sarcasm, a balanced Junior respected deeply. Stumbling into their conversations was like tuning into a podcast where topics ranged from seriousness, like military life, to the kind of banter that had me questioning their maturity, because boys are weird. Junior was our own, everybody here, he was our in-house party starter. Honestly, the man could have convinced a statue to dance. He was the spark behind every impromptu living room dance-off, the reason you found yourself singing your heart out to songs you barely knew the lyrics to, utterly indifferent to the audience. So brave. That bravery, that watch me live my best life and join in energy was so magnetic. Junior lived with a gusto that was all about embracing the moment and its lesson in living that I'll carry with me forever. Now, talking about bonds, Junior and Kensia's was something else. Imagine a closeness so tight, not even light could separate. Oh man, I lost my track. Give me 1 second. I remember once overhearing a conversation they had, Kensia and Junior, and you know me, nosy, I was always in somebody's business. And they were talking about girls. And I was still in my ew cooties phase, so I couldn't really hear it. But I listened with the kind of intensity reserved for eavesdropping and top secret conversations. Kensia, true to Kensia, was like a walking, talking encyclopedia of too much information. But it was their open book policy with each other that truly struck me. They had this honesty, this blunt, no filters approach to their conversations that was eyebrow raising, sorry. Their dynamic was more than just sibling goals. It was a masterclass in how to communicate with love, trust, and healthy dose of reality checks. If my future kids share half the bond that you guys had, I'll consider my parenting mission accomplished. Remember the time that Junior lived with us in 86? I was ecstatic every time I knew that I'd come back home and he'd be there. Him and Danny were inseparable, tied at the hip. He really held Danny down like a big brother would. And your bond with Natalie was so strong. It led to her becoming the godmother to your children. You annoyed Esther so badly. Esther got played, but she loved it. Dina and Nate always had you tagging along on every random errand or party they had, showcasing your role as the ultimate wingman. And we could always never forget the warmest year greetings every single morning in that household. My parents parented you as if you were their own, showering you with love, maybe even a bit too much at times, because you know how Haitians get. But it was all out of love, shared with your amazing mother and sister, your mom, my auntie, who's like my auntie cousin, but you know, whatever. Tia, I always felt you were the cool auntie to me, especially when you would have us play games like crossword puzzles for small cash prizes that felt like winning a pot of gold, making us feel like millionaires when we were young. Those games instilled in me a love for puzzles and chess, which is what I do now, to this day, for my free time. Our games between me and Tuna of hide and seek and Senti evolving into Ding Dong Ditch later on in our years with Clifford and the whole gang. We weren't angels, and we just liked to explore. Some things would have made some of you guys give us side eyes, but if I was going to rebel, I'm glad it was with you, Tuna, my brother. One of the most beautiful aspects of your life for me, Tuna, was the unique bond you created with my nephew, Charlie. It's a bond that will be remembered and cherished until the end of time. I must admit there were moments where I felt a twinge of jealousy over the closeness you guys shared since I was so far, but I was overwhelmingly grateful for it. You were there to capture moments with Charlie that I couldn't. When you moved into Bayshore, closer to Maglev's home in Bayshore, making that relationship strong and keeping close ties with my nieces and nephews. You even brought the bunny ranch to Maglev and Alan's house, which was kind of crazy, but I liked it. You consistently shared messages of self-care, motivation, and positivity online. You didn't seek recognition. You were simply a beacon of goodness for us all. A quote you left on a photo you posted of my brother was, "Fill your life with experiences, not things. Have stories to tell, not stuff to show." That made me think of two things. One, where the hell did he get all of these amazing quotes? Like, where did he always find them? Heck, excuse me. And two, I'm so glad we lived that to its truth. We were truly spoiled by your selflessness, Junior, feeling the warmth of it in every aspect of our lives right up until a few weeks ago. I hate that we lost you to this battle, the battle against mental illness, PTSD, societal pressures, the weight of the world, but I don't blame you. This wasn't your fault. You fought with everything you had. I know you did it. I cry hard because I know you did. I know you must have questioned how you could do this, knowing how much we all loved you. All of us here, we loved you so much. Demons can be relentless, and not every battle ends in victory. But amidst the pain, there's something to smile about. I'm grateful that I never hesitated to tell Junior I loved him, and I got to witness how others loved on him. He did the same for us. In a way, you taught me how to love openly and unconditionally. You welcomed everyone into your life with open arms, making them feel cherished and valued. Junior, you were more than a cousin. You were my best friend, my partner in mischief. I cherish the 34 years of memories we made together. I thank God for blessing us with your presence and for miracles you brought into this world, like Jalen and Juliana. It's still hard to wrap my head around the fact that you're no longer here, that I have to navigate life without you. It's strange to think of you in the past. I keep sitting in my parents' backyard, flooding my thoughts with memories we shared right in those spaces. I keep looking for signs, and they keep finding me. All week, you've been manifesting in various forms, perhaps trying to reassure me, but the truth is, I'm still devastated. I feel like I've been blindsided, like you didn't give us a chance, or perhaps you did give us a chance. It's hard to imagine life without you. I'll miss you more than words can convey. But I promise to honor your memory every day, to never forget the joy you brought into my life, even amidst your silent struggles. Your timing is, as always, impeccable. Navigating through this grief has been challenging. Lots of conflicting emotions. Unsure if it's okay to feel angry, sad, or even relieved that you're free. I practice yoga. So as a yogi, I find solace in acknowledging these feelings and celebrating your life amidst the pain of your passing. My partner in crime, my counterpart in every sense, my Rugrats pamper buddy, the Phil to my Lil, I'll miss you beyond measure, but I'll carry your memory with me, praising your name for all eternity. You were one of the great eight. It's more like 15, but like we're gonna keep the name because he likes to freestyle and it rhymes, so we're just gonna keep great eight. Rest in peace, my tuna. I love you.
If you'll turn over your programs, you'll find the lyrics to How Great Thou Art that we will sing together.
Our brother's gonna stand with me. Thank you, CJ. During this difficult time, we are deeply grateful for the love and support of our family, friends, and church family. I also want to say thank you to the man of this house, Apostle Brown. Thank you for letting us use your sanctuary. Your presence and kind words have been a source of comfort and strength for us. And I want to thank each and every one of you for being there. Thank you. It all started when I was the only child. Then 3 years later, I celebrated my third birthday on February 18th. Just to my surprise, my brother was born 2 days later on February 20th. My mother was nervous that I would be jealous, but in fact, I was excited to have my first live baby doll. I thought I was his mom. I wanted to feed him. I wanted to push his stroller and carry him everywhere. I was full of love because I felt like I met my first best friend. Later, we moved to Huntington in June 1990, where we had most of our memories. I felt like since I had a brother, I had to toughen him up a little bit. I would play every sport with him. At first, he was very sensitive, but when he went through puberty, he would tackle me in football, dunk over me in basketball, and kick my ankles in soccer. Soon after, he was into girls. I remember one time when he was in middle school, he used to walk to his girlfriend's house, and my mom found out. She insisted that she meet this girlfriend. He directed her, and she drove to the girlfriend's house. Then my mom told him to stay in the car while she introduced herself as Roland's mom. So my mom said to her brother's girlfriend at the time, "I heard that you're dating Junior. Is that true?" And she said, "Yes." Then my mom continued to say, "He's too young to date. Don't you know that he still pees in the bed?" So fast forward, my mom would go to work in the evening. So this is me and my brother's chance to run wild and free. We had so much fun. Sorry, Mom. So we would travel with our cordless house phone down the street to play with our friends. Every time she would call us, we would act like we're in the house. They don't make phones like that anymore, by the way. My brother was such a lover boy. I guess that's the Haitian in him. He would meet a girl today and fall in love with her 24 hours later. He loved so hard. When I was a senior in high school, Junior was a freshman. We would wait for my mother to go to work. We would take turns inviting our situations. Sorry, Mom. But me and Junior, we were in competition with each other. I'm like, so who you gonna bring someone this day? All right, this day is mine. That was our little, you know, a little secret. The year after we moved to Bayshore. You mad, Mom? Okay. The year after we moved to Bayshore, he was not happy to start over, but he adjusted very well. I remember randomly asking Junior, "Hey, let's go for a run, 12 midnight." And he wouldn't say anything to me. He would just get dressed and wait by the door. He was really my ride or die partner. When CJ was born, it was like God answered our prayers for another sibling. CJ taught us how to be a kid again. Sidebar, Junior really loved you, CJ. I remember asking Junior to come with me to the mall, and he came. On the way back, I tried to avoid a pothole, but I went into an even bigger pothole. So we laughed for days and days. He's like, "Remember the time you hit that pothole?" That's like our little inside joke. I miss you, baby bro. When Junior graduated high school, he went straight to the Navy. I was so sad without him. Me, my mother, and CJ, we went down to go see him when he graduated from the Navy. We were so proud of him. He was so happy. Then we came back. Then we were sad again. Then he surprised us. a couple of months after, he just came at the door, remember? And he's like, hey, I'm here. But he came back with tattoos all over him, on his wrist, his arms. My mom and I, we were not happy about that. But when I looked at his tattoos, I saw, you know, my brother was a lefty. I saw on his left hand, he tatted my name and my birthday. And I was like, oh, okay, I'm not that mad anymore. And on his right hand, he tatted CJ's name and his birthday. So we got over it. After 6 years of serving in the Navy, Junior reconnected with his high school friend, Brianna. The Fantastics got married and had their first child, Jalen. When I tell you the amount of love my brother gave his wife made him decade of the man. I think my husband is here. But that the day when Jalen was born, my brother was just like, he was like a Superman. Like, he was just kissing on his wife. Like, he was so supportive. And I'm like, Roger, I'm like, you see how my brother is? You better be the same way when I'm giving birth. Where's he at? He's here, right? But yeah, my brother was just amazing. So when we heard his first cry, we were there for the live birth. It was just a beautiful moment. It's like God was there and we felt him. After 3 years later, Juliana was born, and we all felt complete. We had our boy, we had our girl. My last conversation with my brother was the end of last month, and I told him how proud I am of his accomplishments and how I love him. And he said, I love you, Sister Ham. These last words he spoke still goes through my mind. Losing a brother is like losing a piece of oneself. Today, as we gather to honor the memory of Roland Junior Delva, I'm reminded of the profound love and bond we shared. He was more than a brother. He was my confidant, my companion, and my closest friend. His kindness, his laughter, his unwavering support enriched my life in countless ways. Though he may no longer walk beside us, his spirit will forever reside in our hearts, guiding us with his love and memories. May we find comfort in the cherished moments we shared and carried his legacy of love, compassion, and strength forward. Farewell to your brother until we meet again. You gave me.
Can I get a key, please?
You gave me my hands to reach out to man, to show him your love and your perfect plan. You gave me my ears. I can hear your voice so clear. I can hear the cries of sinners, but can I wipe away their tears? Lord, I'm available to you. My will I give to you. I'll do what you say do. Use me, Lord, to show someone the way and enable me to stay. My storage is empty and I am available to you. Lord, I'm available to you. My will I give to you. I'll do what you say do. Use me, Lord, to show someone the way and enable me to stay. My story.
bridge is empty, and I am available to you.
Thank you.
We'll now have the eulogy and reading of the obituary by Odie Jean-Claude, followed by a blessing and song by Keisha Ingram.
I'm not singing. All right. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, friends and family. I'm old school. I have paper. I printed it out. I don't have a phone. I forgot my glasses, so bear with me. All right. My name's Odie Jean-Claude, and today we are gathered to honor and remember Roland, some may know as Junior, some may know as Tuna, some may know as Young Gray, Z, Cigasson, you know, all these names, but well known as Junior. Mr. Junior, I remember when he had Jalen, and I said to him, you know what, at this point in time, I can no longer really call you Junior. I call you now Mr. Delva, Mr. Roland, you know, kind of like a, yeah. I am Junior's first cousin and his favorite. Anybody that has a problem, well, they can see me in the back afterwards. Yeah, but I think he told me that. I am his favorite, right? he wasn't just a cousin to me. He was a brother in every sense of the word. His passing leaves a void that cannot be easily filled. But as we mourn his departure from this world, we also celebrate the beautiful life he lived. Before I get into some of the my personal thoughts, if you would like to just follow me, I'm just going to read the obituary first, and then I'll close out with some personal thoughts. Roland Junior Delva was born on February 20th, 1989, at Bridgeport Hospital in Connecticut to Sina Delva and Marie Roland Jacques. After a year, Marie moved to Long Island with Roland and his older sister, Kensia. Roland attended the Huntington Station School District, forming many close friendships. In 2005, Roland's stepfather, Paul Jacques, moved the family to Bayshore, New York, where Roland attended Bayshore High School and met his future wife, Brianna. In July 2007, Roland enlisted in the Navy, beginning his career as an engine man and serving 6 years. He welcomed his first son, Jalen King Delva, on January 17, 2019, with Brianna Shantae Thompson, who he married on July 31st, 2019. They welcomed their first daughter, Juliana Rose Delva, on August 7th, 2021, and celebrated their union at Sandcastle on November 3rd, 2022. It's a great party. Junior was a hard worker, willing to do whatever it took to provide for his family. He worked at South Shore University Hospital, did freelance photography, and also started and operated Jan Jay's Playpen with Brianna, showcasing his innovative entrepreneurial spirit. Seeking a better life, Roland applied for and received a job offer to work at Duke University in Durham, North Carolina, moving there with his family on September 8, 2023. Junior was loved by many and worked hard to please those around him. With his big cheesy smile, no one would ever expected that he was suffering and struggling with depression and mental illness for many years. Sadly, on March 8, 2024, Junior went home to be with the Lord. While we may never fully understand the depths of his struggles, we can still cherish and hold on to all the fond memories and moments we shared with him. I know many of you here would agree that Junior was more, I'm going to echo this, that he was more than just a relative. He was a friend with a golden heart. He had an unforgettable smile, which was a very big and cheesy, very cheesy smile that was very contagious. He had this warming and friendly presence that made everyone feel at ease and also a willingness to help others that knew no bounds. As I stand here reminiscing about the memories we shared, I can't help but feel an overwhelming sense of gratitude for for Junior, and for just having him in my life. He looked up to me as an older brother, and I cherished that role just as much as he cherished being like my little brother. Sure, I may have teased him and picked on him and beat him up a little bit, just like I did my younger brother Carlton, flipping him upside down, putting him in garbage cans and whatnot. But to build character, you know, it helped to serve as strength in a bond between us that we shared. I watched Junior grow from a tall, skinny, slinky little teenager into a disciplined naval engine man, with small whiskers and peach fuzz on his chin and a little bass in his voice. But more importantly, I watched him grow into a loving husband and a devoted father, a role that he embraced with all his heart. I said, bear with me. Can't beat paper. Our conversations were always filled with laughter, dreams, and aspirations, whether we were discussing business ideas, sharing our love for cars, or planning future vacations. Junior's enthusiasm and zest for life were contagious. Those moments spent in his company will always be engraved in my mind and cherished and remembered forever. As we grapple with the pain of losing Junior, let us find solace, the wisdom of Scripture. In times of sorrow and confusion, we are reminded to trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. This is Proverbs 3:5. And also in Ecclesiastes 3:1-8, where it reminds us that there's a time for everything under the heavens. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance. Though we may not comprehend the reasons behind his departure, we take comfort in knowing that Junior is now in the loving embrace of our Heavenly Father. Junior's legacy will endure through the memories we hold dear and the lives he's touched along his journey. Let us honor his memory by living each day to the fullest with the same passion, kindness, love that he also exemplified. Though he may no longer be with us in body, he is in spirit, and his spirit will continue to guide and inspire us all. Rest in peace, our dearest Junior. You will be deeply missed, but your light will never fade from our hearts. Love you. Thank you.
Amen. At this time, we're just going to take a moment just to celebrate his life, if that's okay. He was young and vibrant, and we have to be reminded that God is still in control and that he's still with us and still cares for us. Amen. So if you're feeling it, you could stand up and act like you're in your living room with Junior, and we'll just celebrate his life. Oh, hear my cry, oh Lord, attend unto my prayer. From the end of the earth will I cry unto thee. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I. That is higher than I. Oh, for thou hast been a shelter for me, and a strong tower from the enemy. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher. That is higher than I. Oh, for thou hast been a shelter for me, and a strong tower from the enemy. When my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher. That is higher than I. That is higher than I. That is higher than I. Oh, like no other. Strength like no other. And it reaches to me. Come on, help me say you are. You are my strength. We need God's strength. Come on, say strength like no other. Strength like no other. It reaches, reaches to me. You are our hope. You are our hope. Hope like no other. Hope like no other. Hope like no other. It reaches to me in the fullness of your grace, in the power of your name, you lift us up. Hallelujah, you lift us up in the fullness. In the fullness of your grace, yeah. In the power of your name, you lift us up. You lift us up. Come on, let's just lift up and bless God for a few moments. Hallelujah. This is where we get our strength. Hallelujah.
And you may be seated. Again, we are reminded today that there are a few things in life that we cannot forget. And one of them is that time itself is deceptive and fleeting. Many times we feel as if we have till tomorrow, we have till next week, we have even another month or year. We make our plans, but God has already laid his out. So with this, I am reminded of the word in James chapter 4. Verses 13 to 15. It says, now listen, you who say today or tomorrow we will go to this or to that city. Spend a year there. Carry on a business and make money. Why, you do not even know what will happen tomorrow. What is your life? You are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes. Instead, you ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we will live and do this or that. I think one of the hardest things with Junior's passing has been in just accepting that he is no longer here. The hardest part has been the acceptance of the finality of the death of this world. We read in Psalm 89, verse 48, it says, what man can live and not see death or save himself from the power of the grave? You see, death is the great equalizer. It doesn't matter how important you are. It doesn't matter how strong you are. It doesn't matter how many friends you have, how young you are. But death must come to us all. And this is the reality that we are reminded of today. But there are also realities that bring joy to a sickened heart. There are also realities that can help heal the heart that has been wounded for those who have been in pain for so long. We're not saying that you're going to be okay in even a month from now, for there are many, depending on the bonds that they had with him, it could stretch for years. But at the same time, I want you to know that there is still hope. As I said, time is deceptive and fleeting, and we think we have forever to make all kinds of decisions. We have another year or two. Let me just get through this summer. Let me just have one more crazy summer. Let me just have one more week. Let me just go to this one last event. But we don't know what will happen, ever. So we are always sitting in a place where if we are not grounded in the truth of what we are and where we came from, then we will always deceive ourselves into believing that there's always more time. Junior joined the Navy. I wondered why he joined the Navy. I said, why don't you join the Army, man? You asked me all those military things, why not the Army? But he wanted to do what it is that he had sought out to do. He had a goal in mind. He had things that he wanted to accomplish, and he chose his route for that. You know, I'm reminded of just looking at him as a kid, and he would do some things sometimes, and you would want to just pick him up and throw him somewhere. But then he'd make you laugh. And then you'd be like, all right, I'm going to let you go. But there are things you don't know about this young man. And he would sit in Sunday school. And I remember it didn't matter what book of the Bible I mentioned. He would tell me the book before it and the book after it. He knew them all. So I'm here to tell you that Junior was more than just an exterior, more than just what you saw. There was a lot going on inside, and a lot of it was very good. A lot of it was very much from the Lord. Aside from the internal struggles, he still had hope. And I'm going to give it to you this way. If you look in John chapter 5, verses 24 to 27, it says this, I tell you the truth. Whoever hears my word and believes him who sent me has eternal life and will not be condemned. He has crossed over from death to life. I tell you the truth. A time is coming and has now come when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God, and those who hear will live. For as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son to have life in himself, and he has given him authority to judge because he is the Son of Man. And this ties in also with Romans 8, verses 38 and 39 says, for I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. I'm here to tell you right now that regardless of what you think, regardless of what you might believe, regardless of whatever questions you have, the first thing is the reality. The reality is he is not here. And the question that you might have has just been answered. Junior gave his life to the Lord at a young age. He came before the Lord. He gave his life. And we are not the ones to speak on anything else. All we know is that the word itself says that he gave his life to him. And how many of you have given something to someone who was stronger than you and took it back? Maybe no one understood that. How many of you have ever given something to someone stronger than you and then taken it back? You can't. He gave his life to the Lord, and it was the Lord's. Regardless of where he was in the world, Junior belonged to Jesus. Regardless of where he moved to, regardless to his location, regardless to the time of day, Junior belongs to Jesus. He gave his life. His life is his, now and forevermore. I'm saying this because, as was said, he suffered internally, and we are still here. And there might be those among you who are also suffering silently, trying to keep everything under wraps. They say that those who laugh the hardest sometimes cry the hardest also. Those who are full of the most joy, sometimes also full of the most heartache, because they feel more. We need each other. There's a saying, it's not biblical, but no man is an island unto himself. No one can stand alone. No one is relying on you to be the sole and solitary source of strength. We need each other, and we need the Lord even more. He put us here together so that we might strengthen each other, we might hold each other up, we might keep each other, that in times of sorrow and grief, that we can reach out to each other, cry with those who are crying, laugh with those who are laughing, to weep with the weeping, to rejoice with those who are rejoicing. That's what life is. That is part of life. And although he is young, and I would never think after performing a wedding so soon after I would be speaking on his death. But Junior was a great guy. We almost had to fight over that name, Mr. Fantastic, I got to tell you, because I already told him, I said, I'm Dantastic. You can't be fantastic, but he already put it online, so I couldn't fight it anymore. So he was a great guy. He really was. And I'm glad for every time he made me laugh. I'm glad for every smart thing he said. And I'm not just talking about just being smart. No, he would say some really profound things at weird times. And I would turn around and I'd be like, who are you? But he would say some things in quiet moments. And I know that he and my brother David, him and David were very close. And David considered him and David and Jamal, those were like the three of them together, forget about it. But they were all very close, and I just kind of, you know, you're a little older, you kind of are in the background, and you're just watching them all grow up together, and you think, then I'm going to be seeing these guys together for years. The reality is that we need the Lord. Junior knew the Lord, and I know plenty of people hear these at moments like this, but if your trust is in anything else, make sure that your trust is sound. Make sure that you've looked at it inside and out to know what you've trusted in this life. For those who are strong, trust in their strength. Those who are rich, trust in their riches. But everything comes to an end one day. There is a finality, and there is one that we must meet at the end. With that, I'm just happy to know that we were there when Junior gave his life to the Lord, and we know that we will see him again in glory. There are a lot of things that people think they know about the word. There's a lot of things a lot of people think they know that the word says, but I challenge you to find it. You know what I'm talking about. Those who know, those who don't know, but there are things you might think you know about the word, and things you think you might know about what's happening in the spiritual and all these things, but I challenge you to find it, because I know I searched, I know I looked, and I know that I have great hope, and I am looking forward to seeing him again in glory. So don't let your hearts be troubled. Believe in the Lord. Believe in Jesus Christ. Give your life to him this day. Don't wait for tomorrow is not promised. Tomorrow is not promised. I know it's late. I won't do an altar call here. But if anybody wants to talk later on, I'm here, and you have many other brothers and sisters. Matter of fact, it's been an honor for me to be able to come and do this as a pastor. There are many pastors in this family. There are many people who could have come. There are many people who could have done this. But at this moment, we're grateful for everyone who is here. I'm grateful for your lives. And I pray that you don't let them go another day without considering that they will end one day. Make everything, put everything in place. Your preparation, not only material, but spiritual also. I hope that this has brought some comfort. And I hope that this has also brought a bit of a moment where we might sit back and just have some poignant thought. And not just to walk away and think, okay, well, we have closure. Closure for one death, but your life is still open. Don't let it go like that. Amen. Let me just close out in prayer. Father God, we stand before you and give you thanks, for you are good and your mercy endureth forever. We know that in your word it says that on that final day when we are with you, that you will wipe away every tear from your people. Father, we know that there is a lot of sorrow in this place now. We feel the loss. We feel the pain of it. But most of all, we feel that because we are still here in this mortal plane. We still must walk. We still must go through. Paul himself wished that he could leave his life so he could be with you, Lord. He wished to leave to be with you, but instead he said he knew he had a mission to accomplish. Samson perished, but in his perishing, he accomplished his mission that had been foretold and took more enemies out in his death than he did in his life. So, Father, we look to you and we know that Junior's life and even in his passing, everything has meaning. Everything has purpose in it and nothing is lost. So, Father, we pray even now for comfort for the family, Father, for you to bring peace once again to the homes, peace to their minds, peace to their hearts. Father, I pray that over the days and over the years, that the memories will not be painful, but they will be joyful memories. That the memories that we have will even remind us of all the wonderful things that we need to continue to pay attention to in this life, for us to pay attention to those who are around us. And Lord, I pray that you will also inspire our hearts to remember to reach out to one another. Reach out to one another when we haven't heard from one another. Reach out to one another when we ourselves are in pain, that we might support, we might help and uphold each other, and that we might accomplish that which we are meant to do. I pray these things, that your name be glorified. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. As before I give the benediction, I want to remind you that in the program you will find the address for the reception. It is on Deer Park Avenue. It is 1114 Deer Park Avenue, North Babylon, the Hibachi Grill and Supreme Buffet. We are going to be meeting there. Please come and talk to people. Talk to each other. Don't just say hi to people you haven't seen in a long time, but talk to each other. There are times where we never see each other. There are faces I haven't seen in years. And as I said, we need each other. And we need to be here for each other. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Et maintenant que la paix, la grâce, la communion de Dieu reste et demeure sur chacun de nous, dès maintenant et éternellement. Amen. Amen. Allez en paix. Go in peace. Amen.
There's a friend who will stay. That God will take the pain away. Say, Lord, incline hear your plea. Hear him in your broken heart.
He'll take the pain away.
Just have faith and believe.
He'll take the pain.
Yeah.
time.